The meter in English poetry is the basic rhythmic structure of a line in or a verse in a poem. It means that the meter depends on the number of syllables in a poem and on the stress, on the pattern, on the rhythm. So the meters are 8 in English poetry, and their names or appellations refer to Greek suffixes. We add Greek suffixes to the meter in order to give it a name. But before we expose the 8 meters of in English poetry, we should define better the meter. The meter is in a line of a verse, a line of or a verse in a poem is called meter. This meter is studied up to a scansion, to a technique of versification put by the author in order to attract the reader. So this technique of versification, which we, when we analyze a poem, we scan it, we scan up to the number of syllables and up to the pattern of stress. Is it the first syllable which is a stress or the second? Is it the third? Is it 1+2 or 2+1, as we saw the iambic, the trochaic, the dactylic, and the anapestic or the anapest. So the meter, when we take a line in a poem, we detach or separate or scan the words into syllables. When you detach into syllables, you got a number of syllables in a line within a number or a set of words. So each two syllables is called a foot. And foot together, they make feet. And feet together make meter. Let me repeat again. The syllable plus another syllable, two syllables, gives 1 foot. And 2 feet or 3 feet or 4 feet or 5 feet or 6 feet or 7 feet or 8 feet all have names in English poetry. If you have 1 foot, monometer, it is mono, called monometer, mono, because it's 1 foot. And remember, 1 foot means 2 syllables. If we have 2 feet, means we have 4 syllables. 4 syllables make 2 feet, and 2 feet is called demeter. If we have 3 feet, 3 feet are made out of 6 syllables, and 3 feet we call it 3 meter. If we have 4 feet, 4 feet are made of 8 syllables, and 4 feet are called tetrameter. If you have 5 feet, 5 feet are composed of 10 syllables, and the 5 feet is called pentameter. If you have 6 feet, means 12 syllables, and 6 feet is called hexameter. If we have hexameter, I want to be more sure. If we have 7 feet, it means 14 syllables, and 14 syllables means heptameter. Remember, Greek suffixes are related to affixes to the word meter. If we have 8 syllables, means 16. If we have 8 feet, means 16 syllables, and 8 feet gives us the octameter or the octave. I repeat, we have monometer, demeter, trimeter, tetrameter, pentameter, hexameter, heptameter, octameter. Monometer, 1 foot. Demeter, 2 feet. Trimeter, 3 feet. Tetrameter, 4 feet. Pentameter, 5 feet. Hexameter, 6 feet. Heptameter, 7 feet. And octameter, 8 feet. The famous meters in English poetry is the pentameter. The pentameter is very famous. Shakespeare alone, with 154 sonnets, contributed to English poetry with his pentameter, which is an iambic pentameter. Iambic pentameter. Anstrous syllable, 10 syllables. The first is anstrous, the second is stress. Together they make pentameter. So you have the iambic pentameter is very famous in English poetry within William Shakespeare. We have also the tetrameter. The tetrameter is very famous in English poetry, especially within the Romantics. The Romantics use too much the tetrameter. Byron, William Blake, Shelley, Shakespeare, all of them, they make use of the tetrameter because it is very attractive. So we have the tetrameter, too much use, the pentameter, and we have the octameter, famous in of course long poems like ballads, lyrics, long lyrics, and even epics. We have another with the monometer. We have the stress or the rhythm. We call it either iambic or trochaic or dactylic or anapes. We have the monometer, demeter, trimeter, tetrameter, pentameter, hexameter, heptameter, and the octameter. And we have in the final of each word, the final line, we have a sound. And this sound is symbolized through the alphabet. The words are alphabets. For example, we have a quatrain by William Wordsworth in Lucy's poems. Strange fits of passion have I known, and I will that tutor, but in the lover's ear alone, what once to me befell. If you want to study the stanza form, the rhythm, the rhyme of this quatrain, you symbolize the end of each line sound by the letter from the alphabet. If the same sound is repeated, so you put the same letter again. Let me clarify it better. Strange fits of passion have I known. It ends by N, so we give the word A, the letter A from the alphabet for the first line, the first sound in this line. Strange fits of passion have I known. The N sound is symbolized with A. And I will there to tell. I will there to tell. We have known and we have tell. We have N and L. So the L is another sound. I'll symbolize it by the word B. Strange fits of passion have I known. A, and I will dare to tell, L sound another, B. But in the lover's ear alone, the N sound comes again, so I symbolize it with, like the first, with A. Strange fits of passion have I known, and I will dare to tell, B, but in the lover's ear alone, A, what was to me befell, L sound, like in the second, and I will dare to tell, L sound is symbolized by B, so I put B. So recapitulate, strange fits of passion have I known, A, and I will dare to tell, B, but in the lover's ear alone, A, what was to me befell, B. We have A, B, stanza form. This is a stanza. The number of lines in a poem has a certain rhyme, and the rhyme stanza here is A, B. The repetition of sounds in a line followed the order of the letters in the alphabets. Okay, A, B. If there is a third sound, we put C. If there is a fourth sound, we put D, and so on. Famous Shakespeare was for the sound A, B, C, D, E, F, E, F, G, G. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. In a sonnet, sonnets of Shakespeare were famous for this rhyme. Octave and sestet, 14 lines if you remember the sonnet. And the rhyme was famous for A, B, C, D, the octave, and the sestet E, F, G. Okay? Famous stanza form and rhyme for William Shakespeare. So this is about the techniques of versification, how to scan a line in a meter, and up to the number of syllables, which make a number of feet, you give a name for your meter, which are, in English poetry, 8. Thank you.